thought I would check in with you. I am on my way to a local bike shop right now. I needed to go get a new chain put on my daughter's bike because hers broke and fell off. But while I'm there, I figured I would take my bike in and find out where I stand. I know I had mentioned in my intro vlog that I was thinking about upgrading, but I didn't really know if I needed to. That's because, you can see my bike right there, but that's because I bought my bike online from a website. I think it was like bikesoutlet.com or bike outlet, I don't know, something like that. Anyhow, I don't know the first thing about bike fitting. I knew I wanted to get into the sport of triathlon, and I knew that I needed a bike to do it, and I had been searching on some different websites about bikes and triathlon and all that. And so I knew that there were different sizes for different people, and it all depended on, you know, how long your legs are, how tall you are, all different kinds of stuff. So I did some research on my own, and I measured my inseam, and I got all fancy with it, and I found out that what frame size I needed, which I think was like 48 to 50. So I picked a bike from that website, the most inexpensive one. I think it was like $150, and I found the size I needed, and I purchased it. And you know, it did really well for me in my first couple of triathlons. I haven't had any issues with it or anything. Being that I'm going to do an Ironman, or I'm hoping to do a half Ironman this October, I thought it might be a good idea to actually go and get fitted. So I'm going to take my bike up there and have them take a look at it and see if I have the right bike for me and for what I want to do. And then, find out about any possible upgrades or modifications that I might need to do to it to get it up to Ironman distance racing. I know for sure I'm going to need to adjust. If I upgrade, I might trade in. But if I do upgrade, I'll probably need new pedals because I'm not currently racing in clipless pedals or cages or anything. I just have a basic flat pedal, and then my handlebars also, and my gear shifters, because right now I've got mountain bike gear shifters that are the clicky ones in the center of the bar. They're not on the front of the handlebars, and that's been really difficult for me because you'll hear a lot in triathlon about aero this and aero that. You want to be in the most aero position, yada yada. That is expensive, okay? And that I just don't have the money for that right now. So I don't even have aero bars on there. But whenever I do get down and into a comfortable position, I always have to sit up to shift gears. And that is so frustrating for me because it does really slow me down and I can feel the difference. But most of the time I just ride on my drop bars, which isn't, I don't know, it's just a really weird position. I know I'll probably need a whole new bike altogether, but we'll see what they say at the bike shop. So I thought I would touch in with you guys and let you know what's going on. And after I leave the bike shop, I will let you know how it goes. All right, I'll talk to you guys later. All right, guys, I just left the bike shop and I am so excited. I found a bike that I fell in love with. Well, okay, so that's probably fantastic, but it's not good for my pocketbook. So I took the bike in. I had the guy at the shop take a look at it, and he immediately knew that it was oversized for me just by looking at it. It turns out that that bike is actually closer to 54 centimeters as opposed to 50, like I thought it was. But the good news is that he did fit me while I was there, and the frame size that I actually need is a 50. I tried out a Trek, and it was a gender-specific bike, so it was made specifically. The frame was made specifically for women, and it was a dream. I'm a girly girl. All right, I have pink tape, handlebar tape on my bike now, but this bike was the most beautiful color of Tiffany blue. It had white handlebars, and it was perfect. One of the things I noticed right off the bat was that when I got on it to do the test ride, the gears were, actual road bike gears, like the modern style, not these mountain bike style that I've got in the center. And so, you just click to shift at the front, and it was so easy. It was so fluid. The bike was so smooth when I rode it. I loved it. It was not nearly as expensive as I thought it was going to be. I think it was on sale for close to $700, which is great. I actually found out that they have a layaway program there, which I didn't even know that bike shops did that. Layaway, guys, best thing ever. 20% down and then 3 months to pay it out. I think I may have found myself a bike. All I have to do now is go home and sell my husband on it. So I'm really excited. I know for sure I'm gonna retire this one. I'll probably give that to my husband because it's probably closer to his size. He's like 5'8", or something. He's something like that. 5'8", 5'9", and my little 5'3" body just was. Yeah, it was great. The whole experience is great. They sized me and everything. So if you're curious about buying a bike or a road bike, or you're curious into getting into the sport of triathlon, I highly suggest going by your local bike shop. Even if you don't have any intentions of going in and purchasing anything, let them size you. They got the bike that I was trying on. They got it fitted for me, like the seat height and everything. He checked all the angles to make sure everything was great before I took it out on a test ride. And yeah, so it was great. I mean, I would highly suggest anyone going if you're curious as to what kind of bike you need. Let the professionals tell you, because quite obviously buying your bike on the internet and checking your own measurements is not a good idea. So I will talk to you guys later. Thanks for checking in. All right, bye.